Welcome back everybody to my next video. Today we're going to look at a First Strike ration. This is a 24 hour ration from 2015, the 257th day, menu number 5. And this I got in a trade with Gundog. I'll put his contact information, his link to his channel, as well as some of the other MRE reviewers in the information at the bottom of the video. So have a look if you get a chance. I'm going to tear this open. We're going to go through the contents. This is part one of a two-part video. So we're going to try doing the tear test. Take that at the top. Doesn't want to go that way real easy. We're going to take these serrated edges and see if we can tear it that way. Not easily. Durable packaging. There we go. That is a lump of food. So I just weighed this before I took it out of the packaging, and we're looking at 2 pounds, 10 ounces worth of packaging and food here. There's not going to be a lot of packaging weight. This is going to be mainly food. So you're looking at almost 2 pounds, 10 ounces and a little bit. There is a lot of food here, so what I think I'll do is break it down into different types of groups and bring you back periodically. Okay, so I've broken apart the contents of the pouch here, and I'm going to bring this up to you. May or may not have enough light. If this doesn't work, I've got a still shot of it. But this is the ingredients of the Ameriqual First Strike Ration. Okay. Now, I looked at the different parts of this, and I looked at it, and I thought, you know what, there really isn't any grouping of two or three items together that work as a meal for me. So the way I'm going to look at it is this is something that you would be looking at probably being on the move all day. You're going to be looking at eating every hour to hour and a half to 2 hours, just taking one of these packages, one of these products, consuming them, getting your energy back up, getting your vitamin level back up, keeping your protein, your carbs balanced. But constantly eating. This is not something where it's 3 sit-down meals. When I look at meals like the Russian style, where they have multiple tins of pâtés and meats and multiple crackers, etc., that sets more to me like a good, solid 3 sit-down meals. So let's look at the different packages in this. I'll cut in and out of scenes and look at different combinations possibly, or just individual products, and then you can put them through however you would use them in a day. If you've got your BDUs on, you've got some thigh pockets, you've got your ankle pockets, you've got shoulder pockets, you could hide one of these around your body, you could hide two of these around your body and still carry a lot of kit with you and not have it being obtrusive in one single big honking pouch. Stay with me. So the first meal I thought, start the day with cinnamon bun shelf stable. I'm gonna bring that up, try and get it to show us the details here. I'm gonna bring it up tight, see if it goes macro. Pull it away, and there's a lot of ingredients in here. So that's a cinnamon bun, that's breakfast. Put that together with some trail mix, this is nut raisin mix, with pan-coated chocolate discs, 66 grams worth of stuff here. Hopefully I can get this without too much glare. There's the information. So the way I looked at this from the package offerings was this is a little bit of a gut filler for your tummy in the morning. It gets you on the road, gets you rocking. Next up, we have the corn nuggets. This is toasted corn kernels. These are toothbreakers. I've had these as a kid. Now that I have medical dental bills and dentists and such, I'm very wary of these little suckers. I don't pop them in my mouth and crunch them right away. I let them sit, get a little bit of saliva on them, soften up a smidge, and gently put them between the molars. Hope you can see the details there. That's snack item number one. We have a toaster pastry, frosted brown sugar, but listen to this. I don't think that held up real well in shipping. I think that's gonna be breadcrumbs in there, but nevertheless, it's consumable. It's not gonna hurt you. It's just not gonna come out of that toaster the way it did when mom used to make it before you went to school. There's the details. Hopefully you can read the ingredients. Pause it if you need to. Another good on-the-move snack here is a first chocolate flavor, First Strike Nutritious Energy Bar. Here's a date code, 5246. This is 1.2 ounce, 35 grams. And if you flip it over, there we go. Try and get you the details here out of the glare. Hopefully you can read that. Pause it if you need to. Throw it up on the big screen. Next item we've got here, this is something I would consider like a lunch type item, a little heavier. This is sandwich, shelf stable, honey barbecued chicken in bread. I am looking forward to this. That'll be in video number 2. We'll be trying all this stuff. Here's your information for ingredients. And we've got the nutritionals. And this one's labeled with a date of 5/169. 2015, 169th day. Now the next snack that I'm looking at, this would be a post-lunch snack. This is a sugar hit. This is, my buddy Gundog loves these, Zapplesauce. 4.5 ounces of applesauce enhanced with maltodextrin for increased performance. Everybody remember Malto Meal? Does that stuff still exist? There you go. There's your details. Hopefully that picks up. Date-wise on this one, I got a stamp around the back here. We're looking at 5/2/28, so midway, halfway through the year, or a little bit later, 2015. This one is turkey nuggets. That's a new one to me. I haven't seen that before. Feels like there might be 3 to 5 nuggets around the size of that Mickey D's place. I'll get you the details here, if you can read them. Okay, there's one part. There's the other part. A little tougher to read. I'll try the next set down here on the ball, in the bag. And the ingredients are over on this side. Okay, that's a bit of a protein hit. So now if we're getting later in the day, we still want some energy, but we don't want to fill up our tummies necessarily before dinner. Here's a mixed berry energy gel. I'll bring that up closer. There we go. Date code on this one. Stamped in the side. Looks like a 5/194. So this might be your dinner type of meal, or your later day meal. We've got a Star-Kissed Tuna Creations, lemon pepper tuna. There's 4.5 ounces of product in here. Lightly marinated premium chunk light tuna. On the back we've got more information. I'll bring that to you. Now if we try and pull a date code out of this one, I'm looking up in here, and it's kind of hard to pick up. So I'm not sure what that date code is. I'm going to have to leave that out for you. I'm just going to check the other side of the package. I don't see anything crimped into the sides, so I'm not really sure. Maybe I'm just being thick-headed, but I don't see a date code in there. If anybody can figure that out, is it maybe 2015, 118th day? That's probably what it is. 118th day, 2015. Okay. Now, this wouldn't necessarily be paired right up next to it, but this is going to give you your bulk to fill your tummy up. So we've got your good old-fashioned crackers. Try and get the information up here for you. Put my fingers out of the way. Some of the extra words. So that's a pack of crackers. Date code on here. You're looking at the back of the pack now, 5/2/11. And with that, you could of course spread the peanut butter, which, go figure, contains peanuts, sugar, oil, etc., cottonseed, rapeseed, vitamin B6, thiamine. What I usually talk to some of the other MRE reviewers, we discuss the fact that very few of the MREs that we see in IMPs contain an actual tablet vitamin. And I would think with a 3-year shelf life of most of these products, just a regular good old-fashioned high-test multivitamin, or perhaps vitamin C as well, wouldn't be such a bad idea. Or if they put you something together, even putting a high-fiber type element in there just to get the bowels moving. Here we have an item that would be a throughout the day item. If you needed an energy kick or an energy boost, you could take consume one or more of these cool mints with caffeine. It's also got vitamin B6 in there. This complete package contains approximately 85 milligrams of caffeine, which I looked it up quick. If you're looking at a can of Red Bull, you're looking about 80 milligrams. And if you're looking at a Mountain Dew, you're looking 55 milligrams. And the average coffee, they say, ranges from average 40 to 80 milligrams. So it's not a huge amount if you take it pill by pill here and there, but it will be a bit of a stimulant. If you need a big boost, chomp them all in a hurry, and you're going to get that boost to your body, and hopefully you can deal with the downtime after the withdrawal occurs. You might have been saying, how do we eat all this stuff? Well, we've got the good old-fashioned MRE spoon, and we've got the accessory pack. So for the accessory pack, we have 3 moist towelettes, 1 larger bag of iodized salt. This contains salt, potassium iodide, etc. Net 4 grams, so there's a fair bit in here. We've got some TP. We have some matches that are designed especially for damp climates, but they will not light when wet or after long exposure. So there's a little, maybe a very thin waxy coating under. I can't feel it. It feels like a regular match head. And lastly, couple of chiclets. So you also might have said, "I'm thirsty," which is what my son says every few minutes when we're out on the trail, and he's not run out of water, or he has run out of water, pardon me. So in this package we have two drink bases. We have a beverage base, powder orange, which I've had before, more vintage than this one. But you just open that up and you do about half a canteen cup and give that a good stir, or give it a shake if you do it in the bag. It has a zipper top up here that you can reseal. Be doubly sure that it's closed. There's your nutritionals. I'm gonna scroll them through. Hopefully the camera's picking that up properly. It looks like it is. And my date code. Let's see, where's that? Crimped into the bottom by the looks of it. And looks like a 5109. So that's a one. The other side of that is your chocolate protein drink powder. So that's one if you're doing a carb-heavy snack or meal, like some of those crackers, etc. You can do one of these with and balance it out. So there's your details. Scrolling through. As always, pause it as you need to. There's the ingredients coming up. There you go. And there's my thumb. Date code on here, we are looking at, looks like a 5230. So there's your two drinks. And another thing that I look at a lot of the Canadian and American MREs and IMPs is with the worldwide stuff. You see in the UK, they've got usually water purification pills. I believe Russia has the water purification pills as well. That would be a pretty cheap addition to get into these soldiers' meals and to help them get safe water no matter where they're stationed or what theater they're in. Personally, I carry about 20 pills just in my first aid tin, in my Altoids tin when I'm out hiking and camping. Just because you never know if you're going to need it, and if it's there, it's great. If you need them and you don't have them, that's when the problem happens. The last thing we have as a content is this large resealable bag. So if you don't consume everything, you pop it back in here, you pop it back in your pack. Or, like I said earlier, you could pop it into the pouches on your pants or into different pouches on a pack or a rucksack or a day ruck here and there to make it accessible as you need it and keep the other stuff buried in the pack until you want to put it so it's more accessible. And there it is, everything packed back into that secondary pouch. So that's the whole package, the whole ration back in there. So it does fit all of the product. And at this point, I will do as I always do and say thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you're on Instagram, follow me on Instagram under the same username. And we'll see you on the next one.